Hi and welcome to Kids Workshop. This is take two. I forgot to record, so I have to rehab again that I did before, but then I forgot to record. So I have assembled this one as last time, the episode 4, we had two halves. I glued those together, and then now we have a hole. And then I used filler and a lot of fine filler, it has to be. And I used a lot of sanding, and then I painted it. And after I have put propeller on, there is a little brass wire in the kit, and a plastic propeller, and then there is this rudder. It's a wooden stick from here to there, and then the rudder is two pieces that was in this. I cut out of this. You can see this one and this one, and I glued them together. And then I had, you can also see it on the drawing I have here. You can see like this. See this, and then this is the wooden stick here, this one, and then there is a brass one. And then of course I drilled a little hole into the body of the, before I put the rudder on that one, that's of course. And then I cut a couple of small bits of the list I used to the haul. And you cannot, if you have exactly the same one as I have here, you cannot entirely depend on what they are writing, because it's not all true. Something, a list they call a box and so on. And there's errors in this one, but it's a pretty sure. But I would have preferred it to have been a little more precise. Because they said that this kit was a very easy one. It's some of the, it's one of the easiest kits to make. So, and I have preferred a little more hand holding, because I use it in the, I have built a lot of these, so I don't have any problems. But when I use it in this kids workshop, I want kids to be able to build it, but kids are not, just glue guns and the tubes from toilet rolls and that sort of thing. Kids are also on 10 and upwards, or 8 upwards, or so. I build. We will make a lot in for different ages, but this one I will say 12 and upwards, and you have to have a lot of patience, and kind of have tried something before, like to do it, and want to do it. The one part is very, very, very needed. So, and then I put this fender list on, and that is a kind of hard, because it's a kind of a thick. I don't know if I have one piece of it left. It is here. I have a piece of it left. And it's kind of stiff like a match stick. And you have to bend it around this corner here. And you can see it's kind of very, very sharp corner when you have to bend the stick on. So start in this end and then use normally when we put this as a list on the hall, we used just painter's tape, but we are not using painter's tape for this one because we have to kind of forcefully make it bend. So I'd use this black gaffer's tape. The color don't have any importance. It's just I made a lot of strips of this, and then I started put it on here and one on here and through all the way through and take it easy, and then you will succeed at last. But as I told before, you can feel the fiber, you can feel the willingness to bend in on the wood by trying to do this and this, and there is a difference, a small difference. Even on a piece of paper you can feel. I will, because the fiber in the wood are different, so do it this way, then it's you can feel what way it's feel easier or what. Yeah, I am sure you understand. So take it easy and do it, and then lots and lots of sanding before you. And I know no one like to sand a long time, and be careful with the filler because you have to sand it down again. So don't just put a lot of filler on it, because that's get hard as stone and take a lot of time to sand down. And use a 80 grit to start on sandpaper, and then use a 240 grit later on, and that's good enough. 240 grit at when you are finished and have it all smooth and fine, then you can use 240 grit and then it's fine. But when you think you're finished sanding, then take a half an hour more. So sorry for that, but that's how it is. So now I am started to put I'm not sorry. Sorry, we start this way. I have not put this on yet because it's easier to put the deck planks on before I put this one on. But I put this, you can see we have two of these, and we are putting those on at last, so we get a kind of a railing on it, or what we should call it. And I of course have built this one, a kind of cradle it can stand on. It's also in the, you saw it last time, it's in the, also in the kit, and I gave it some stained colors, and you can see here and here, and then there is the list here are a part of it. You, this one is a part, is in the kit also, between the, all the list. So, but as you also can see, we have pretty much used all the, I don't have room. We have pretty much used all the parts in the kit. We have two here. Oops, we're gonna use later on. Now we broke this one, but there's no more in it. And then, so practically we only have the cabin, the wheelhouse left in the kit, and some boxes on the deck and so on. But and then we of course have all the small details. We have them in this box. I have put them in here. You can see we have some stuff here, and we have the sail and some thread, and we have some brass stuff, and a lot of different small stuff some we will put on later. But now we are, when we are finished with all the wood stuff, we will do that. We will remove this one, and we broke that one. So, and of course this one is empty too. Don't have any more stuff in this. And then we have, you can see we have something here also to the deck and whatnot. I'm not entirely sure, but we will figure that out when we get to that. So, but the part now is we are putting deck planks on. And just before I restarted and retake, I decided to put a thread sewing, a darker brown sewing thread in between here, in the what do we call it now? I forgot. And in the drawings or the instructions, I will that was the word. Instructions, they are talking about taking a pencil down between and draw it that way. But I preferred, because I have done this on a another boat I made years back. So, and we start up in this. And this, we will even do it. And this part, yes. And then we will go down here, and do not cut too much, and do it a little at a time, because otherwise you will regret. Shall we see? See? And then we put a thread in between here, then you get these nicer, what shall we call them, kind of drawings between the stuff. And just before we got on, we figured out that, put this one down here, we figured out that it was easier to draw the thread to the glue than is to do it in any other way. Because we have to be careful not to put too much glue on the list, because the list are, when we are gonna lacquer them afterwards. Why can I not figure this out? Okay, use the big thumb then. So, give it to me. Or maybe not that hard. Just before it went very easy. And now I kind of don't. You know, I don't have to hold anything, it just, so it sticks. And you get this nice. Okay. No. It don't work that way. So I will do it this way. Oops. So, does it work? Now, if I may, there's a lot of glue here, but I have a wet cloth right beside me, so we can use. No. And don't use too much glue because it don't really hold anything. Just wanted to stick to where we wanted. So and the first one I guess I have said it, but I'll say it one more time if I haven't, that the first one you have to hope. The first one you have to put in the middle. Because then you are sure you cover the crack between the two holes. You know. So. So. And can we figure out a smarter way to do this? I'll try something else this time. not good enough. Nope. Need a little tougher angle. So, should that be it? Yes. Ah. That was better. And that was wrong. No. That's a little too long. No. It's okay. A little glue. Ah, maybe. Tenth of a millimeter. It get easier then. So, and on we go. Yes, that's what I will do. And as you can see, I sprayed it. I'm sure you'll use a brush, but if you can spray it, it's get a nicer finish. Oh, don't shake that much. A little difficult to hold this without touching the glue. Kind of have to hold your breath, and that's difficult for a long time. Oops. See, the idea was now that I could, not that close. The idea was that I could, not that one. Could put this one in here, but as you know, Not all ideas are good. And then it, of course, sticks to the finger and nothing else. So, maybe that idea was good enough. Maybe we'll use one of these sticks here. Get down there, please. Okay. Clip this one. That didn't work. Too weird. Thank you. So, why but it's the herbs. It gave this fine drawings, I think. And you kind of can see between the planks. But you can see, you can use a lot of time. It's not because it's difficult, it's just because it's time consuming. This is right, and how far is it to down there? And you have to think on it, kind of goes this way in there. So that's why I can do it right to the. Through the railing. Whoop. Or maybe that was a little too long. Yes. We will cut. We can always take off, but we cannot put it on again, unless we glue and all kind of stuff. We don't want that. Still too long. I'll take it a little at a time. Sooner or later you will get there. And then it will fit, right? It did. Now I cannot get it up again. Oh, there is no other way. Sometimes when you repeat a thing, then you kind of figure out easier ways to do it. But I don't think we could, of course, put on there. Maybe that was the easier way. And then, yes, we do that next time. And then we only have to hold like this without getting it on the fingers. We'll do that next time. Get in there. Not that much. We need to have something in between. Has it grown? So. Go down there, please, and stay there. Patience, patience, patience. And I draw it down. And if you don't have patience, then stubbornness will do it too. Guarantee you. The problem here is you don't have all day when the glue is kind of getting stiff. But you can still move around with it. This end, it didn't go that well. get it down there. So it can play a little with you. So, and then it but take this one. The glue I use is ordinary carpenter indoor white glue, so there is no hocus pocus in that. Can buy that everywhere, I think. And I just use the indoor type because this ship are not coming out any time to sail in lake. But you could build it so it could. Then you have to change a little on the drawings because you have to have a place in the hall for the motor, but you could do it. You could do it. And then you had to put some ballast down the bottom of it. So we will carry on. I guarantee you that it's not in it. How lucky can you be? Like this, stay here. So, am I pushing through the camera all the time? I think I am. Oops, that was very close cut. And now we need to have a little dent in here. And do that. Where did I draw it? Here. This side. There we see. You can see we come to all those on a moment too. We'll take it up a bit. Oh, it went off on its own. See? Right. But I think I will do something. I will put a white cardboard. On here, so that you can see it easier to see this way. Ah. Don't do that too many times because you kind of make damage in the paint. But I have the paint, so I will kind of take it off. See, now you can better see what going on when I'm cutting. I just have forgotten that part. Not that part. Oops. I hate when it's... Oops, the camera must be... So... Move a little. So, and then we told ourselves that it was easier to do this, or at least that's what we want to try. And oopsie. Normally I used to have my needles on here so that it's easier than this thick, but I just dried out of needles. I have a lot of these, but I no more needles. I have to buy some in the drugstores. But as you can think, they are very fast to dry out. The thinner the tube, the worse it is. See? And now I didn't get my hands all glued together. I do stick my head in the camera all the time. I can't help it. Come on. No. Boom. Boom. It's because I have glue on my fingers, so old glue. No. It's a little tricky, but we will make it work. So get down I will not get down there. So that's another good one, that one. Yep, yep. So see if we can cut this. It's funny that we can't do it like that. And the other end. That was too short. What happens? And on we go with the next one. Come on. How does that fit? We don't know yet, because now we have this in the way. How much is it? It's not that much. Can we see if it kind of fit? We need a this. So we have a little more wriggle room. Yes. Yes. Oh, and in the east end, we have the same problem. We need to cut in here. Up the turn around. Before we make the cut, we'll see if it will fit. It kind of will. Say it like this. Oh no. It's all the way over. I didn't see that. Yeah. You could have said something instead of letting me. Carry on with that. And we will put some glue on here if we can figure that out. And why? Oopsie. That was not the plan, but it was how it went. And then we will remove the glue later. The glue for the thread. On. Thank you. That was very nice of you, sir. See? And we will one more time get a piece of this fine thread. And put it on, put it on. Where is it? Here is it. close the door. I think I have to wash my hands. Much good one. Need to get this one, even the squeezer. Come on. Thank you. So, and now in the washing machine. So it get fine when we come lag on it. Put one more, the last one for today. That's not that, it's a small one. This one. And this one is only going from here it's enough to we can get the thread in and then kind of have to do it like this. So, shall we see if that was not enough, and that was not, the angle wasn't steep enough. But what about now? That and now it's too long. But now it's like we want it. Do like this. Then it will hold the thread also. So stay there, please. Oh, nay. No, 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 no. Don't do that to me. Ah, I thought it was free. Now it is. So Whoop, 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 whoop. Too much. Can we stretch it up again? Nope. I took it all out again. That was not the intention. See, and on it will go until, and we have a little fella over there crawling around, and on it will go until the whole deck are finished. So, next time we are on, what is it, next Tuesday, these are on, and those are on, and we can start with the cabin and or the wheelhouse. It, I think it, the name is the wheelhouse and the mast and all the fine little stuff, and that will take a lot of time too. So go away, bit of little guy. I cannot go away. I cannot hit him. But I can take a broad stroke. Wheelhouse and mast and I don't know how far we get, but at least this are on. But you can see if you are persistent and you have a boat, right? More or less, now you have to get in from the weather in it, and I also have a lack of the deck when I'm on. But I will say thank you for today, and hope I will see you to episode 6. And remember, all the episodes are on my site, pixelfantasies.com, and there you can find 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 5, and a lot of other built trebuchet or whatever we have done. We have done a lot of things, and over the time, there will be a lot more. So I will say bye-bye, and see you again Tuesday.